chip is determined.
Oh, they're just never over, are they?
There's a caution. The 98 of Chase Briscoe spun. No. That would, no, that was a zero.
Zero?
Yeah.
Chief for Justin Allgaier. The question is, what does the crew chief for Cindric do? Look at just the amazement. Unbelievable for the pit crew. And the reason I said that is he has a new set of tires. Last night, the championship leader stayed out. Other cars kept tires, beat him, lost the championship that way. This is a view from the 98. You see all the smoke. There's 10 cars on the lead lap. So does that make your decision easier to come to pit road with only 10 cars, but you know you only have potentially 2 laps to get up front?
Well, here's the problem. Well, if everybody's going to pit who has tires, you see Allgaier and Chastain, no sets, and everybody else is set on the lead lap. Well, if everybody's going to pit, well, yeah, you want to pit, no, bring new tires and restart in third. But what happens if Cindric makes the same decision, comes to pit road, and say 4 or 5 guys stay out? Because I'm telling you, if I'm the crew chief to the 9, if I'm the crew chief to the 1, and the 22 pit, I'm staying on the racetrack. I'm going to try to help my teammate. I know people don't like multi-car organizations, but I can do it by doing what's best for me is also best for the teammates. Really good when that lines up that way. There were 50 laps on their tires last night. Tonight, there's only 28 laps on the leader's tire. Jeff, you're Cindric right here. It's not about winning the race. You only have to beat Allgaier. We saw the 98 spin around, and Haley back in 8th. I stay on the racetrack, and I tell Haley, come get some tires and come get me. I am not pitting from the lead on a green-white checker for a championship.
See the silence from the driver? You don't like making these decisions.
I don't know. Tell me what to do, man. I don't want to make this decision.
Oh, here you go. Oh, my goodness. He takes the left, comes to pit road, and gives up the lead.
And look at who's following him. A lot of cars following him. This first time by, it's only lead lap cars that could come to pit road with him. So that means there's going to be quite a few cars that came with him, and not very many that will be a cushion for the 7th, Kelly.
And Justin Haley did bring his number 11 to pit road. You don't see him there in the shop. They had one set of Goodyear stickers. Goodyear's, there he is. Said the car was pretty good, especially on new tires, Parker.
Discussed the truck race last night and what you saw there, and they decided to put these 4 fresh Goodyears on to give all the good we can, Marty.
All the championship contenders who had Goodyear tires left come to pit road. Chase Briscoe said he felt like the left rear tire went down, but looking at that replay, it appeared as though all the tires were up. He said he literally went into turn 3 and just swapped ends on them. You also see a very big track bar adjustment once again, trying to tighten up that 98 inch truck. I think we have fresh tires starting a little further back. Can't Allgaier hang on?
So many teams have referenced the truck race from last night. Let's show you how that final restart went. As Steve, you mentioned, the guy who was leading was far enough back.
Is that bright yellow 23 Moffitt? He was the leader on old tires. You just look how the tires come by inside and outside. Just no way to defend all the runs.
Look at the car, the truck, that 2 truck on the very bottom of the racetrack. He restarted 8th. He goes on to win the race. But Steve, your point about the number of laps on those tires, almost twice the number of laps on those tires as compared to what Justin Allgaier has on his right now.
So now we're going to have to figure out what lane they start. And that's the other thing that I think helped tires, Jeff, is now you can choose. You can kind of move up a little bit. We're not quite to the choose yet, but eventually we're going to see where they all choose. Currently, Allgaier leading. The 22 of Cindric, though, is in the 3rd position. Let's listen in to the radio on the 7.
All right, so do I even want to know how many lead lap cars stayed out?
It really doesn't matter. You're just going to have to go like hell, all you can. Green white checkered right here.
You know what? Sometimes I like with the, you know what, man? Let's not look at the negative. We'll look at the positive, which is funny because my man, Jason Burdett, I know him very well. I won't say he's the most optimistic fellow. He's normally painting the other picture, but doing a nice job there. Telling his driver, it doesn't matter what's behind you, man. We got to go. We got 2 laps.
Focus on what's in front of you. But Steve, he made the right call. He had new tires and could not beat the 22. So at least he made his swing. He tried to make it happen. And now he has, at least he has track position. So if it doesn't work out, I still think he did the right thing.
But there's no guarantees. We can see another wreck. We've seen five wide on the front stretch. I mean, they're in the picture. They've raced all year to make the playoffs. They raced the whole playoffs to make the championship four. Now they've raced 100 and or 200 laps at Phoenix to be in the championship picture. Well, here you go. Here's the chance. Here's the opportunity for a championship. You have older tires. I'm sorry, is what Burnett wants to tell him. But at this point, I can't help you.
Now the four is going to be a wave around. Jesse Little's going to go by the pace car here in just a moment once they get everybody lined up. Then it will be Justin Allgaier's decision to choose either the inside or the outside lane. The only other car, and this was the information that wasn't delivered to Justin Allgaier, the only other car that stayed on the racetrack that was a lead lap car was the 10 of Ross Chastain. So those two are on older tires, the 22 of Austin Cindric, the freshest tires, and he's going to restart third.
All right, Jeff, you're the driver. Tell me the perfect scenario for the 7 as far as the choose lane. Where does he go? Where does he want the 10 to go? Where does he want the 22 to go?
Justin has to go back and think about his race car, right? He's got to go back and think about where is his car the best. Is it on the bottom? Is it on the top? The main thing, though, Steve, is the great launch. He's got to get a great launch. He's got to take advantage of having this track position. He's got to enter turn one with the advantage. He cannot enter turn one side by side with somebody, because if he does, those new tires are going to eat him up. His opportunity is in the Geico restart zone and getting the launch. That's where it's got to start.
Well, here's the choose. Let's see. New this year.
He's going to the bottom. I'm going to run with it with him.
He's going to the top.
I think that's
better. Ross Chastain chose the bottom.
I think that's better. I'm surprised Cindric took the top. I thought he wanted to be at the bottom with the new tires with only two laps.
I think that's an interesting call also. I really, with this racetrack as wide as it is, Steve, with those new tires, where can the 22 go? Now that he's picked the top, where is he going to go with those better tires?
Because remember, Rick, remind everybody one more time, because it's going to be crazy. You do not have to win the race. You have to outrun your others. So Allgaier, championship competitor. Cindric, championship competitor. Dave.
The red 7 finished. Allgaier, this is the next chapter. And do you really want to be a crew chief? Tough on Jason Burnett, but he's made the call that he's made. Older tires now. We'll see if they can hold on, guys.
Look, in the outside lane, in the fifth row, is the 98 car. He is also a championship contender. And then behind the 20 is the 11. He is a championship contender. They both have tires as well.
We're in overtime, presented by Credit One Bank. It'll be two laps to go.
Man, just no guy.
Austin Cindric in the 22, fighting behind the 7. Ross Chastain holding his ground on the bottom of the race.
Oh.
Here comes Noah Gregson on the inside of the 9.
Oh my gosh. Oh.
7's got the 22. Austin, though, his teammate is saving on the 9s on the inside of the 22.
He's giving him all he can handle on the 5.
Man, just no guy. Oh. Oh my God. Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
How about that, guy?
the champion, has won the final race of the season. This was his 100th start. Think about that. What a milestone.
And the flag,
that flag that we just saw is going to be handed to the driver of the 22. Austin Cindric is now the Xfinity Series champion. Tied Sam Hart earlier this year when he won 5 of 6 races. Think about the run he was on there and the company that he joined. Sam Hart, one of the greatest ever to get behind the wheel of an extended car. Megan, it's time to celebrate. That is Austin Cindric's
mom. Well, I think I want it on the 7 of Justin Allgaier to win. But, it's his first championship. What? I'm okay.
Celebration for Austin Cindric and his crew and family tonight.
Okay.
Thanks, Kelly.